Okay, I'm still setting a few things up, so don't mind me. First I need to input the game, of course. Okay, let's get started. Welcome if anybody is watching, and welcome to my next live stream. What I'm planning to do today is show off a little tournament that got announced in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, which is exclusive to people from the Benelux, Belgium, the Netherlands and Luxembourg. A little tournament was set up by Nintendo in those countries, and I thought might be fun to show that off. Might be a fun change of pace when it comes to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe content on this channel. It has been a lot of Star Warrior Cup. In fact, it's been the only thing I've been showing this game off. So, yeah, and since I had an extra day, didn't have any video for one of the weekend days for this weekend, and therefore I thought might as well stream this tournament, because normally I do not. It's not one of the first tournaments I've played, as you may know, but usually I don't stream these, but since I had the time to do so this time, I thought, might as well do it. Might be fun. And yeah, I'm not surprised, a couple of people here are Dutch as well. Kinda expected I would attract a couple of Dutch people, so therefore I might say a few things in Dutch as well. Like this actie hier. Ja, en ik ben inderdaad Nederlands. Dus bij jou kan ik Nederlands antwoord geven. Zal ik af en toe wel doen. But because most of my viewers are international, they're not just from the Netherlands. Therefore, I thought might as well still do this stream in English. But anyway, I think we need to get into this game. Because tournament's about to start. Yeah, there is a code. In fact, it's a pretty good suggestion, because I still have to look that code up myself. I have not played this game in a few weeks, so I did not really have the time to input that code. I know where I can find it. Okay, I'll input it in the chat as well, so people can join in if you're from the Netherlands, Belgium or Luxembourg. But anyway, this is how you enter it. Go to online play. Tournament. Search by using a code. And the code is 1175 76 86 12 27. That should be it. Yeah, there we go. This is supposed to be it. But anyway, you can see the code on screen right now, so you can join in if you also want to play this game. I wouldn't know why not. I'm not the biggest pro when it comes to Mario Kart 8, but I still really love playing it, so therefore I definitely didn't want to miss it. In all honesty, ever since the Star Warrior Cup came up, I never really played this game on my own anymore. I don't really have to, I feel like. I'm getting my grief in the Star Warrior Cup, which is monthly, which I also participate in. And therefore, on my own, I never really play this game, and also don't really have the time to do so. There's a lot of other games that I also want to play, and I don't want to give that up just to play this game, so therefore I might be a bit rusty, so don't expect any miracles from me when it comes to getting some results. But it should be around 7 o'clock now. That's when it's supposed to start. Yeah, it's 1900 hours, so let's see if we can get this thing going. Okay, when it comes to character selection, like I said, I'm more of a casual player than anything else in this game. So I usually don't really care about any good combos, and therefore I usually just pick whoever I like. Might as well go for Ludwig. It's one of my favorite Koopalings, so... what do I want to... I'll just go for the golden combo this time around. Always really like that. Okay. Would be nice if my stream did not... Okay, it's still working. I was kind of afraid it's... I don't like any of these courses. Let's go with this one. Not really one of my favorite tracks, but... had to pick one. Okay, but the way this tournament works is actually... like this. It will last for an hour. Max, so it's going to end on 8 p.m. That's the time it will end. And in the meantime, you have the chance to do a maximum of 12 races. Whenever you've raced 12 races, the tournament for you will be over. That's basically the way this works. Man, only one from Belgium. The rest is all Dutch. I was expecting a little bit more 50-50. But okay. That's what we're going to have to work with, it seems. It would be nice if we don't get a combo error immediately. Let's see if I still kinda know how this game works. Oh man, there's a lot of lag here. Who's the guy with the bad internet connection? Man, this feels weird. Never happens in the Star Warrior Cup, I know. Oh, dang it. I'm getting last place immediately. Hell yeah. I have to try to concentrate a little bit, because I don't really care about winning, like I said. I don't expect anything from me. Not the biggest pro at this game, so therefore... I wouldn't be surprised if I do... pretty bad, but on the other hand, I also don't want to get last place immediately. Should be able to beat at least a couple of these guys. Let's go, Bullet Bill! Oh, that one lasted for a really long time. Make sure I don't get hit with the other one incoming. Ah, dang it. I was afraid that might happen. Yeah, I'm kind of expecting you to not have a defense item anymore. Time for a shortcut. Somebody's throwing a boomerang at me, I think. I hear a boomerang. Yeah. No, you're not. Oh, you had more than one. Okay, third place, not bad to start. Seeing how I was in 12th place for the majority of the first lap. That could have ended a lot worse. The one Belgian player was last. Not really a good representation for your country in this room, it seems. But okay, that was my first race. It was not the best of my races, I think, but still. I still need to get used to this game again. Because, like I said, it has been a couple of weeks since I last touched this game, and there I played on with a different combo, so this one kinda need to get used to again. Okay, race number 2. I'm hoping for Donut Plains 3. Obviously, it's the only one of the tracks I really like that's in here. A lot of Cheeseland in here. There's a track I really don't like because of the ending part of Cheeseland. You can really cheese that track at the final part. Usually people start going with slow starts there, and that's something I don't really like. The slow start strat is a strategy that people use in the beginning of a race. Deliberately not starting immediately, wanting to be in last place at the start of the race. And whenever they're in last place, they can get better items. They try to get Starmen and Mushrooms, and they try to keep that for the entire race and then start spamming them in the final lap and using the shortcut here. And I think that's a really, really cheap trick to use, so I'm not a big fan of that. Not a big fan of those kinds of strategies in general. I always like my games to be fair play. And I don't really think the slow starts is a good fair play strategy. Okay. Red shot was not going towards me, so. Somebody fell off, so going to give me an extra spot. Yeah, this is the part I was talking about. As you can see, you can really cheese this part if you have a mushroom here. I know I have a mushroom too, but I'm also kind of scared for what's happening behind me, so I want something to defend with. That's why I'm dragging this green shell. Didn't want to throw that yet. That was an accident. Oh, dang it, missed the double item box. Can you give me my mushroom back? Thank you. And please use the shortcut again. I'll use the other one. There's two shortcuts you can take here, but I'll take the other one so I can get an extra item box. Hey, come on! What the hell? That kinda was somewhat unfair. I kinda forced to use this immediately. Oh, shock dodge! Everybody got lightning but me! But I do miss the item boxes, so that's a bad thing. I'm not going to gain up on you because you have a red shell. You stay ahead of me. At least until I can defend that. Ow! Chomp, why? Give me the double. Ah, dang it. Just get some mushrooms here. And another third place, it seems. Okay. There we go. I'm not doing too terrible. That could have been worse, once again. I always claim to be a lover of chaos, so in this case I'm kind of forced to go for Baby Park. what can I say? Usually I don't do this, but let's go for that was fun. Because it was. For me it was, at least. Hi, Menno. Good to see you here too. Apologies that this is going to be in English for the most part. Maar je mag af en toe wel wat Nederlands zeggen, dan zeg ik wat Nederlands terug. Still think it's really funny that there's only one Belgian person in here. Man, race 3 already. Already a quarter of the way done. It's the only downside, I think, of this cup that they introduced, this seasonal circuit. I think 12 races is a little bit too short. They should have made it a lot longer, I think. Around 30 races or something max. It would have been way better. But it is what it is. Why didn't I see that? Oh, it did hit too. At least you should have been hit. Still went up. Probably because of the lag. Someone in here that doesn't have a really good internet connection, I feel, because it doesn't really feel as smooth as it usually does when I play. It's also something that can't really help. I was afraid of that. I'm always so good at hitting everything. I know I'm not the only one, but still. No! I had defense items, why did I still get hit? Too late to boo! Did want to press it, but the moment I press it, I already got hit. Man, I used to get third places, remember? I like Electrodome as a track, but I'm really bad at it, so I think I'll go for Thwomp Ruins. Might be a better chance of me getting some results there. But okay, usually whenever I play Mario Kart 8, I usually play in a different tournament. But can talk about that for a little bit if some people are not too known with it. The Star Warrior Cup is actually something I've been uploading every month on this channel so far. That's usually the only tournament I play in, with a group of friends from the United States and Great Britain for the most part, that I'm a part of. That is actually a monthly tournament that we usually play in. Really like playing with that gang. And that's actually, nowadays, the only real way I play Mario Kart 8 Deluxe nowadays. Before that became a thing, I did play it a little bit on my own sometimes, even though not as many as when it came out in the Wii U. It was definitely... I played it a lot more when it was still on the Wii U, Mario Kart 8. I did decide to buy it whenever it came out on the Switch. But in all honesty, I never really play it all that much on my own anymore. I kinda... got tired of the game, you might say. And I usually only play it on special occasions, like these tournaments with a group of friends, or a tournament like this between fellow countrymen, including Belgium and Benelux in this, or Luxembourg in this case, because of the Benelux. What the hell? Hey, what the hell? Why did you put me back all the way over here? I was already. Okay, never mind. Ah, of course he still hit me. I'm getting a last place, watch. Ooh, blue shell. It's an item I never get. Yeah, it already feels like I'm the only one who hasn't practiced for this yet. Bam! Usually it's always pretty scary trying to save up on a bullet bill, because if a lightning happens, the bullet bill will be gone. I should have seen that coming. use a boost so nobody can hit me. Ooh, shock dodge! Hell yeah! First place is too far, so I can't get him or her. Well. Ooh! Yeah! I think I stole that victory! That is how you win. Thank you, Boo! Well, at least I've won one race. Not really sure I deserve that win, but I'm taking it. It's probably going to throw me into a spectating round now. Wouldn't be surprised. Usually happens after four races, then the rooms get shuffled around. You get seeded into a new room. Do we have some new people here? Looks like it. There's two of the same. There's probably someone who's playing with two players. Because that is also an option, of course, whenever you play online. You can also play two players. If the second player uses the same me as the main player, the player one, then you'll get the same me. There's probably someone who's playing alongside with someone else. But, Tom and Mega Mike. And this time we don't have any Belgians at all. Nothing but Dutch. Zet hem op, Nederland. I thought this was supposed to be a Benelux tournament. I'm seeing nothing but Dutch people here. Okay, we've got Baby Park 2, I always call this. Because it's basically Baby Park, only with a wider track. Ah. I'm also good at missing item boxes because of not being able to see it coming that somebody ahead of me is going to go for the same item box that I have in mind of going for. That, ow. Did I mention this track is Green Shell Hell? Green shells here can be pretty much hell because of the long straightaways. Whenever you throw green shells here, it's really easy to hit someone. You're kind of forced to look behind you a lot here if you don't want to get hit. Ooh, got it. I was hoping for something better, but still, I'll take a red shell. I'll keep the mushroom, I think. The turn, I can cut the turn if I time that correctly. There we go. No! Ooh, bar bombs are pretty deadly here. Oh, there's nobody there. How did I miss that item box? That's not fair. Definitely hit that item box before the other dude did. Man, I'm losing a lot of positions now because of that. No, go away with the green shells. Once again, I'm very bad at looking at which item box I should go for. At least a couple of people got hit extra, but still. Yeah, that happens to me a lot too. That's just the way Mario Kart works. You always get those kind of moments where you get where you do really good, like you've seen happen with me a couple of times. That I am pretty in first, second, third place, and then red shells happen, and you end up getting 11th or 12th place. It's a pretty normal thing, Oxy. It always happens in Mario Kart. Okay. Didn't expect anything when I first started this, but I won at least one course, even though I shouldn't have. Let's go... Oh, random. Oh no! Not Rainbow Road 8, I hate that track. This is by far my least favorite track in this game. Which is remarkable, because usually Rainbow Road is my favorite track in any Mario Kart game. This game, it is my least favorite track. I really don't get how this track works. I'm never able to get the proper tricks in. I always get last place here. We'll see how it goes. Might prove challenging. There's especially that ending part of this track I'm really bad at. I always fall off the track there. Or just take the turns wrong and lose a lot of positions. There's a shortcut on this track that people usually take, but I'm always unable to do so. I usually just skip that. Oh! The worst part is, I saw that coming, and yet I still got hit by it. Yeah, this is the shortcut coming up. Oh, I did it correctly for once. I usually don't. That's usually what gets me in this track, that shortcut. People, oh, Starman. blue shell incoming, so... Always stay on the side of the tracks whenever blue shell's incoming. Because the blue shells always go across the center of the track. Oh! I got sniped. Bob-omb snipe. Okay, let's go. Those are not the best items you can get here. I can use the shortcut for a wee moment. Okay, let's make ourselves invisible so we're able to get hit by that guy. Oh, I already had an item. Wasn't paying attention. I thought I only had one mushroom and nothing in my second item box. Yeah, that was pretty predictable. I lost my defense because of not paying attention. It would be nice if we get another blue shell. Okay, I got a mushroom out of that. Oh no, you gotta be kidding me! No, don't fall off there! Oh, dang it! Remember me being in first. Dang it. Getting 7th. That was a waste. Should have won that one, but I started making mistakes after that. Blue shell. And I was all hyped. I was finally going to win Rainbow Road for once. But no. Okay, Royal Raceway, without a doubt. One of my least favorite tracks in Mario Kart 8 Deluxe, in all honesty. Also, but I still really like the way it works. It's mostly the aesthetic I don't like when I talk about that. Definitely like it more in Mario Kart 64, where it originated from. Man, there's people with 70 points already. Despite me finishing low a lot, I'm not doing too terrible. Oh, green shell. Ah, you missed me. It was pretty predictable that green shell was going to get thrown at me. I It's not going towards me, so don't worry. I don't really have any use for that super horn, so... There's an opening in his defense, so I can hit him now. There we go. That's the only downside of triple items. You do have a lot of items to defend yourself with, but you do have a tendency to still get hit. And he obviously got triple reds. Yeah, I don't really have enough defense for that. Okay, blue shell incoming. Stay away from first place. There we go. Stop it with your fireballs. Can't really remember agreeing to that. This should be a defense item. Thank you. The game will never give you 2 coins whenever you pick separate item boxes. So if you've already got a coin, a second item box will never give you another coin. Okay, unless you have triple reds, you're not going to beat me. No, only 1 red. Okay, thank you. Second win. Did not expect that on a track like this. Astor, that's actually the guy from Hyrule Warriors Age of Calamity, right? Was one of the was the bad guy from that game. The guy with the golden steering wheel. Okay, we've already seen Cheeseland, so might as well Warrior's Gold Mine. Most of the people are going for Warrior's Gold Mine, it seems. Yeah, chances were pretty high that one's going to get picked then. Would be nice if we can get some more Belgiums in. Man, 8th race already. Only 4 more after this. Let's go! This is a track I really like, actually. Both the original and its remake here in Mario Kart 8. I really like Wario's Gold Mine. I think I like it a little bit more in Mario Kart Wii. Mario Kart Wii is one of my favorite Mario Karts in general, so basically like everything from that game. Even its Rainbow Road. Oh, bomb. Couldn't avoid that. Yeah, I'm in last place. Remember me being in first place last race? Should stop missing item boxes. I miss all the item boxes way too much. Oh, oops! And I'm in last place again. Where I belong. I could use a bullet bill right now. Starman is also fine. Let's find a good spot to use it. Green shell is not something I was hoping for. Okay, it's better than nothing, I guess. Someone with green shells behind me, so I'll use it to defend. Triple mushrooms. Blue shell incoming. really use that. Straight for that. Okay, I'll take a third. Was a possibility of me winning this, but yeah, the stupid banana that kinda made it impossible. Okay, the final group this is supposed to be. It's not a full group. We have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 7. Okay. That would make things a little bit easier. That's actually something I usually don't really like in Mario Kart 8 whenever you play online. I always prefer having a full group. Okay, here come more people. Shouldn't have made that remark too soon, but still. I can elaborate on that story a little bit more. Usually when you are in tournaments like these, or just when playing online in general, worldwide or regional, I always prefer being in large groups, the full 12 people. It does not always work, but whenever you get in empty rooms where you have only 2-3 people, sometimes even only 2, that does not feel right whenever you have that few people. I don't really like it when that happens. Oh, dang it. I'm the person with the most points in this group. That's putting some weight on my shoulder. I'm not too sure I want that. But okay, let's just try to do Mario Circuit from the GBA. This is definitely a circuit that I didn't appreciate until Mario Kart 8, because where it originates from, Mario Kart Super Circuit, I am not a big fan of this track. I don't really like this track at all honesty there. Feels way too bland, too boring. But the way they worked with it in this game, I'm a definite fan. I definitely like what they did here. Hey, WJS Gamer got online. He can't play. He's also someone who plays Mario Kart 8 a lot. He's from Great Britain, so he can't play today. It's Benelux only. Oh, was it really that far ahead? I get blue shelled and I'm still in first. Okay. People get mushrooms there, then you're pretty much screwed, because so you can take a pretty big shortcut there in that final turn. Do need a mushroom for that. Somebody's throwing a boomerang. I did not have any defense. Usually people behind you start bombarding you immediately when that happens. Yeah, I was afraid I was going to get screwed here. Me having to avoid that bomb that he threw, that really wrecked me here. First place couldn't quite get that, but second place should have been doable for me. But that bomb he threw was really well aimed. I definitely got scared by that. And me having to deviate from my path definitely screwed me. Okay, Super Bell Subway every time. By far my most favorite track when it comes to this set of three. It's even very high up when it comes to my favorite track in general. It's not my favorite track in Mario Kart 8, but it is pretty near it. Let me just tell you that. I really love Super Bell Subway. Maneuvering through the train tracks and even the trains themselves, it always feels really fun to do. We've got some new people, I think. I saw somebody leave, so... 85 points seems to be the highest number in this group. But okay, we have Twisted Mansion. It's definitely not one of my favorite tracks. I do like the aesthetic of this. I really love how they designed this horror house, you might say. This haunted mansion. That is really well designed. Just the track itself, I'm not the biggest fan of. I'm always scared that people are going to throw that green shell backwards whenever they drag that. But they usually don't. People usually try to use them for defense. The chances are not very high that whenever you see someone dragging a green shell that they're going to throw it backwards. They usually don't. Ah, still got hit. Oh no, shouldn't have used that mushroom yet. Oh. Wanted to save the... Ah, come on, I still get hit by the backwards green shell. Really, green shell in fifth? The gamers really hate me today. It was pretty predictable you were going to do that. I can use it, the mushrooms here. If I don't get hit by bananas... Yeah, you can use a shortcut here in the end too. Ah, come on! Getting destroyed now. Let's make sure you people stay around. Dodge that bullet bill. Make sure not to dodge the shell. And another blue shell. Ooh, that I can use. Ah, come on! Press the L button! Why did it take so long for all the items to get sent out? Really bad. I wanted to spam for that Starman I got because I knew I was going to get hit if I didn't. But for some reason it didn't want to register all of my items being used. So I first had to spam through my mushrooms before I was able to use that star, of course. But for some reason my button mashing the L button did not really want to work. Okay, that was race number 10, right? There's still two more, I think. It used to be the one with the most points in this group. That's no longer a thing. Oh, doesn't matter. Yes, race 11. Two more races. Okay. This is also a track I really like in Mario Kart 7, and pretty much just as much here. It would be nice if you get rid of that red shell. But don't dare use this mushroom. Towards me. Ah, that always happens to me here. Really bad at avoiding those notes, those music notes. Come on, hit someone. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, another Starman. In fourth place, that is not a bad thing to get. Oh, even the guy in front of me has a Starman. Okay, let's make sure not to get squished again, because I usually do. Hey, there we go. See, I can do it. Sometimes. No, you don't. Oh. Well, I still was able to get the items, at least. Oh, just that turn. Oh, first place was over there? Hey, who took my mushroom? Everybody's really close now. Oh, everybody missed the item boxes there. Oh, there's not a good get for items. Dang it, missed the mining section. Okay, not too bad. Just hoping for something better, but luck didn't want to go my way in that final lap. I'll take a fourth. It's better than some of the other rankings I got. Of course, the persons with more points were in front of me. But still, I broke 100 points. It's not a bad score for only 12 races. Seeing how I'm getting destroyed most of these tracks. Okay, I would really like to finish this off with Big Blue. I'm a very, very big F-Zero fan, if you don't know. It's definitely my favorite racing genre by Nintendo. F-Zero. Really, really bad it stopped coming out. We haven't had an F-Zero game in years, unfortunately. I'd really like to see one, and I would like to celebrate that by getting Big Blue in the final race of this Spring Cup. And I'm definitely not going to win. But I don't care. We're not doing this to win. Ooh, yeah, there we go. Let's go, Big Blue. Complete with F-Zero music, even. Definitely would have liked it to see an F-Zero game coming out on the Wii U or even on the Switch the moment these tracks got added to Mario Kart 8, because they weren't in the original Mario Kart 8 at first, of course. These tracks were all DLC tracks, and the moment they started putting in these F-Zero tracks, I really thought, hey, Nintendo knows of the existence of F-Zero again. Perhaps they might even make a new F-Zero game now, but unfortunately they didn't. Maybe I was hoping for it the moment these tracks were added to Mario Kart 8. It would have been nice. I'm not giving up hope quite yet. Even after all these years, I still have hope an F-Zero game might eventually still get released at some point again. Two people pretty far ahead of me, so I will use a Starman because I feel like I'm getting destroyed otherwise. Yeah, I would have been hit. Ooh, shock dodge. Let's see if I can make use of that. Okay, there we go. Hell yeah, first place. How did you hit me? Did you also shock dodge? Probably did. Otherwise, you wouldn't have been able to have that item. Oh, we're doing so well. I'm getting last place again now. Ah, oh, come on. It's not a good way to end. Yeah, I'm getting last place. Well, almost last place. Okay, that could have ended better. The moment the final section entered, I was really feeling like I was going to win that track, but no, I was not allowed. Okay, that should be it. The rules of the tournament were that only 12 races were allowed to be raced, and that I did, so we're getting thrown into spectating rounds now. And usually what happens if you're not allowed to play in a tournament, you'll be thrown into spectating rounds. So for me, this was it. It was pretty fun trying this out. Like I said, in the past I did do a couple of these tournaments before. Never streamed it before or recorded it in general. But it was fun trying it out, even with YouTube going. Usually I do a lot worse, in all honesty. But the last time I did one of these Nintendo-organized tournaments was actually still in the Wii U time. On the Switch, I don't believe I've ever doing one of these tournaments before. These Nintendo-organized tournaments. So I thought, might as well try them out at some point. I had some time to spare today, so I thought, might as well try it out. And since I had a couple of open spaces in my schedule, it's mostly because of the Super Soccer project I'm uploading right now. I did have some open spaces. I usually try to go for a video every day, but whenever I close off a Let's Play, I don't want to start a new Let's Play in the same week another one has ended, and therefore I sometimes have some days open, not having an upload. Normally I would have done something different, like a Super Smash Bros. Video I usually do whenever I have these open spots in my schedule. But since this came by on my path, I thought, might as well do this. Make a stream out of this. It's also fun. I need to have an excuse to live stream every once in a while, because of the way my upload schedule works with my VODs. I don't always have a lot of time to live stream, but whenever I get a chance like this, I always think, might as well try it out. And I must say, it was a lot of fun. Mario Kart is always fun. Anyway, that's the beauty of Mario Kart, I always think. Mario Kart you can usually approach in two different ways. You can either go for winning, or you can go for just having fun. Having fun with the chaos and everything I do, I mean with that. And that is something that usually ends up happening. But okay, as you can see, 1535 people have entered this tournament, which is a lot. I don't even have to bother looking at the ranking, because of the way I did, I'm not even close to ranking. As you can see, most of the people are in the 150s. With my limited experience of this game, I think even breaking 100 points is already pretty much a miracle. For 172 points, by the way, you actually have to win every single race you race, because you're allowed to only race 12 races. And winning gives you 15 points, so you basically have to win every single course, give or take. It looks like the guy who's in first place right now did not win every single course, because if he would have won every single course, you would get the maximum of 180 points. But still, that might still happen. The tournament officially ends in 8 minutes, so if people still haven't had their 12 races, you can still go beyond the 172. Chances are not very high of you doing that, because like I said, you basically have to win every single race. You're only allowed to lose one time, basically. But yeah, this was the Spring Cup. This was the... what's it called again officially? Seasonal Circuit Benelux Spring Cup. That's officially what it's called. 4 tournaments in all 4 of the seasons. This one obviously being in spring. And in summer, autumn and fall, winter, another tournament will be held, which will also last for an hour. Basically the same deal. And every single time a winner will be crowned, and even a grand final will be held when all 4 of the tournaments have been held. That's basically the way it works. And it's organized by Nintendo Benelux, so it's only for people from the Netherlands, Belgium or Luxembourg. We did not see any of them. They should be around, but Luxembourg is not a very big country, so the chances are not very high of you meeting them, but they were also allowed to play, but we did not see them. But anyway, this is all I can give you for now. It was fun doing this, it gave me an excuse to have a video, an alternative video, because of me having two spots open in my Super Soccer project. This did make me postpone the start of my weekend project, because I usually always have Let's Play also going in the weekend, on Saturday and Sunday. Therefore, the weekend project for this weekend will be Sunday and Monday. So the first episode of my next Let's Play is going to be tomorrow and Monday. It will still have two episodes in this weekend. It's only going to shift towards Sunday and Monday. And then the Super Soccer project will have four videos in the week. Because of me having that open spot, that's the way I solved it. Next week, the same deal. But next week I will not be live streaming unless some other tournament gets introduced in the meantime. And I might. But I only do live streams in special occasions, like I said. And this was one of them. But if nothing comes on my path, next time I will simply continue with my Super Smash Bros. Online tourneys, where I try to win tourneys with every single character in Super Smash Bros., also something I'm still doing. I did not have the chance to do that a lot lately, but next week it's going to happen again. But this was a small little detour to Mario Kart 8 Deluxe. It was pretty fun to try out, even though I still think I could have done a little bit better. But even if I had a little more luck, I definitely wouldn't have even come close to the 150s or 170s that all these other guys were getting. But hey, we weren't playing to win. Most of the people weren't. As you can see, there were more than 1500 people playing in this tournament. And only one can win, so the chances are not very high that it's going to be you. Unless you're really good at this game. But even though I consider myself not very bad at this game, I also don't consider myself a pro at this game. Because I simply don't play it enough. But still, I did pretty decent. Breaking that 100 points mark was a fine little milestone to reach. Okay, and when it comes to the rest of this seasonal circuit, Benelux. Unfortunately, I don't have the exact dates on the next tournament yet. It is supposed to be held in July. I believe Nintendo Benelux's website said it was going to be in July, in the summer. There's no exact date yet, but I will try to also live stream that one if it comes up. Because I definitely want to do this again. This was a lot of fun. Seeing all these Dutch people and the occasional Belgians. It was still a lot of fun. But for today, I'm going to close it off. I don't really have anything else to say, I think. Other than closing off this video. Seasonal Circuit Benelux Spring Cup has ended with me getting... How much was it again? 106, I believe? Was it 106? Come on, show me. Oh, 104. 104 points. So, even though a lot of people beat me, I'm pretty sure a lot of people were also below me. Because I can't imagine this being a very bad score. The final room I was in, I already saw a lot of people with a lot less points. So, I have nothing to be ashamed of, I feel. I did everything I could. Seeing how I'm not a person who plays this game a lot anymore nowadays, I still feel this went pretty well for my doing. But anyway, we're reaching the 1 hour mark of this live stream. The length this tournament was supposed to last. The 12 races I was allowed to race went a little bit below the hour mark, so it ended a little bit early for me. It's pretty nice by Nintendo that they stretch out the time slot a little bit. Because otherwise, because of a spectating round or something like a comm error or something, might prevent you from getting 12 races in before the hour. So this way you do get a pretty big chance of you reaching those 12 races. But anyway, I hope anybody who's going to watch this back or is watching it now has enjoyed. At least I have enjoyed playing. And next Mario Kart 8 video is going to be another Star Warrior Cup again, I think. Unless I'm unable to attend to that one. But usually I am able to. Most of the time they are on Sundays, so usually I have time on Sundays. So most of the times I can reach the Star Warrior Cup. But that's going to be in the next Mario Kart 8 Deluxe video, probably. Even though that one's going to be without commentary, because of somebody else already streaming that, and I always like to be in the live stream of that, talking to the people I race against. Therefore, I am kind of forced to do that one without commentary, but it also gives me the opportunity to edit it a little bit, so you don't have to get worried by the waiting screens and the comm errors and the spectating rounds. So I usually don't really mind. But anyway, this has been Mario Kart 8 Deluxe for today. Next time is going to be in the second or third week of July, I think. But you will hear from me when that time comes. I will put another annotation for live stream incoming whenever the next date is set. So, I will see you next time. Tomorrow my new Let's Play will start. My new weekend project, even though it's going to be postponed for one day because of this. But I hope you'll enjoy that too. And all of my other videos, of course. It's the whole reason I'm making them for you guys. Even though I also enjoy making them myself. But anyway, I will see you anytime, anywhere. Treeks out. See you folks later.